Dear students, today we are going to discuss the applications of Taylor series in derivations of general heat conduction equation. If we go back in the discussions of Taylor series expansion, then applications of Taylor series expansion is generally used if the function y equals to f of x is given, and if you know the value of x1, this is a y1, and if x2, which is equals to x1 plus h, is given to you, and if you are not able to know the value of y2, then according to the Taylor series expansions, your functions at x plus h value, it will becomes f of x plus f dash, means the first derivative, into h divided by 1 factorial, plus the second is f double dash x into h square divided by 2 factorial, as is going on up to the nth level. But in general practices, the terms which is having a higher derivatives, suppose this is from higher order derivatives, that is second order and third order, that terms we are neglecting, and our equation is becomes f of x plus h equals to f of x, and if you write a derivative in the form of d by dx of f of x into h, here this equation is used to calculate the value of functions at x plus h from the value of x. Now we are going to discuss the applications of this Taylor series expansion in general heat conduction equation. Let us consider one slab. One side temperature is T1, another is T2. And here the temperature T1 is greater than of T2. It means a heat is traveled from this T1 side to the T2 side. And if we arbitrarily consider one plane, if the distance between these two planes is L, and if you consider the plane at x distance from the T1, and if you know the value of heat transfer, that is Qx, and from this, if you want to calculate the heat transfer at the another plane, which is apart from the current plane by the distance dx, so if the heat transfer is Qx plus dx, using this Taylor series expansion, you will be able to calculate the value of Q at x plus dx, which is equals to Q of x, it means according to here it is fx, plus del by del x, or you can write d by dx of the particular functions, and that particular function is Qx in this case. So Qx into h. H means a distance between this x1 and x2. So here there is a two plane, one is at x, another is at x plus dx. So the distance between the two is dx. So here you have to write a dx. This is very important expressions that we need to use in derivations of general heat conduction equation. Thank you.